In this video, we'll see the interrupts available in 8051. So generally, the program counter keeps on executing the instructions in the program sequentially. But whenever an interrupt occurs, at that time, the program is stopped and the program counter jumps to a new location where the interrupt service routine is written. So for every interrupt, there is a separate vector address. At that location, the program counter jumps and it starts executing the instructions which are written from that address location onwards. So this small set of instructions is called as interrupt service routine, and it is used to perform a specific task whenever a particular interrupt occurs. The last instruction is written as RETI. So this instruction is used for coming back to the main program where it was interrupted. So this is an example how the interrupt works. So this is a program this program is executed sequentially by the accessing the sequential instructions. Then at particular instant, if suppose an interrupt occurs, then the program counter jumps to the ISR of that particular interrupt. And this ISR is nothing but a group of instructions which is used to perform a specific task. And the last instruction in this interrupt service routine is RETI. So with the help of this instruction, we can come back to the main program where the program was interrupted. So after this, it will return to the main program and it will continue the execution of the main program. So this is how the interrupts will work. So every interrupt has a vector address. So vector address is the address of program memory, and it is unique for every interrupt. So whenever an interrupt occurs, the program counter jumps to a specific vector address and it starts executing the instructions which are stored from that vector address location onwards. So in case of 8051, we have five different interrupts. External interrupt 0, it is having vector address as 0003x. Then we have timer 0 overflow, it is having vector address as 000b hex. Then we have external interrupt 1, it is having vector address as 0013x. And timer 1 overflow, it is having vector address as 001b hex. And finally, we have serial interrupt, it is having vector address as 0023x. So all these vector addresses are of program memory and those are unique for every interrupt. Another thing to note about these vector addresses is that there are only 8 memory locations between every vector address. So 8 memory locations are not sufficient if you want to write a complex interrupt service routine. So in that case, we have to jump from this vector address location to some other location in the program memory, and there we have to write the interrupt service routine. So this is a standard way of writing a program whenever we are using interrupts in our system. So the first instruction should be as jump main. So the program will start from the address 00hex and the first instruction is as jump main. So when this instruction is executed, the program counter will jump to the label main, which is written over here. And here we have to write the main program. And whenever any interrupt occurs, at that time, the program counter will jump to the specific vector address of that particular interrupt. For example, if the interrupt of external interrupt 0 occurs, then the program counter will jump to the vector address 03hex. So here we have to write the interrupt service routine of the external interrupt 0. Again, if it is complex, it is having more number of instructions, then we have to write that interrupt service routine at some other location in the program memory. And we have to jump from this location, that is 03hex, to the location where we have written the interrupt service routine. So for that, we can use instruction ljump and the name of the interrupt service routine. So it will jump to this label where the interrupt service routine is written. And the final instruction there should be RETI. So it will come back to the main program. So this is a structure of the program whenever we are going to use the interrupts. So in 8051, we have two external interrupts available, external interrupt 0 and external interrupt 1. So in that, again, the external interrupt 0 is having pin P3.2, and external interrupt 1 is having P3.3. So these external interrupt pins are used for interfacing the external peripherals to 8051. So whenever the peripheral, external peripheral, wants any servicing from CPU, at that time it will generate some sort of signal on any of these two pins. So that signal will help to interrupt the CPU. So CPU will be generally executing its main program, and whenever the external peripheral requires servicing from CPU, at that time it will generate a signal on any of these two pins. So it will interrupt the CPU. So CPU will stop its program and it will jump to the interrupt service routine related to that particular interrupt. So this is how the external interrupts will work. Then the SFRs are required for controlling or configuring the interrupts. So those SFRs are TCON, IE and IP SFRs. So these SFRs we'll see in the next video. So this is about the interrupts available in 8051. In the next video, we'll see in detail the SFRs required for configuring these interrupts. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.